Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment and welcome to another episode of Bus Mechanic Simulator. Today we are on an articulated bus working on all the tire pressures that need to be checked and adjusted if necessary. On a bendy bus. Okay, well, first of all, before anything else, hi Andre. You might wonder why I do that. Well, that's because I was very happy to hear that VIS, who honestly, I had no idea that VIS was the developer of this, but very pleasantly surprised when Andre reached out to me in the comments and said, hey, by the way, we do watch your videos and we are the ones developing this. So awesome. And I have to say, good job. Good job. I'm very pleasantly surprised. Wow, speaking of overinflated tires. That's as overinflated as some YouTuber's ego. Oh boy. I didn't talk to anybody in particular, by the way, but hey. Do, 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 do. Oh, look at that. That one is spot on. Spot on, I say. So, the last stream of this was actually quite interesting. A, not many people knew about the game, which was really surprising to me. B, what I found more interesting even, is that I apparently was completely blind in terms of features, I should say. Blind, ignorant, whatever you want to call it. But thankfully, a couple of you wonderful people told me about my shortcomings in terms of how to use this, and there's actually quite a few very nice features in here that help you very much so with getting stuff done in a timely manner and getting stuff done in a fashion that helps us to be fast and efficient, namely camera options that I didn't know existed. And I guess I must have been ignorant, because I thought I read everything about it, but unfortunately that was not true. Now, that all being said, we are done here with this. Oh man, I didn't even realize that. Now that I'm looking, VIS, of course, VIS. I feel dumb. I really did not catch that VIS had their subtle branding that they usually use on stuff. But I was really happy to see that Andre is still watching my stuff every now and again. No. Don't be falling down. That was easy enough. And we are ready for the next. And signed off. Yay! Total points 1020. Engine's air filter needs to be replaced. Now that is easy. Oh! Hello! Hello! I like it. I like what I see here. Alright. Nice double decker. That's still in the bench. We said air filter, right? Air filter would be up here. Come to think about it. No. And for that, there goes the air filter. Okay. So, let us head into here, and then we need engine. Air filter. Beauty. I really love the detail on this. It's great. It's absolutely great. All right, wait. There was Q and E, right? Yes, Q and E. That was one of those things. No. No, not the grill. Did I already put the grill in? No. No, I did not. Now that was interesting. It's a little bit backwards, but okay. Fair enough. Bye-bye. Another one. Let's see. The air filter would be up here then. Let's see here. Throw that away, throw that away. Do not throw that away. Do not throw that away. And again, the one thing that I really love, well, there is a lot of things that I like about this, but the one thing that I really, really, really extremely like is the fact that this shop does look like an older mechanic shop, like pretty much the age of the shop where I did my apprenticeship. So that makes me very happy. Okay, so apparently we have to put first the filter in. I don't know if you know that, Andre, but that's a little bit backwards. But that's okay. Good. Now, all tire pressure needs to... Another double-decker. Tire pressure needs to be checked and adjusted, and the gearbox oil filter needs to be replaced. That's fairly straightforward, too. Gearbox... no. Not fairly straightforward. Well, it is fairly straightforward. Okay, now I'm wondering if I can, since we don't have the ability to lift that middle axle, if I can just go ahead here and air test this. I will find out in about 10 seconds. Yeah, I don't know why I wasn't able to do that the other day. Because remember when I said... now that's kind of weird, because normally you can just check the tire without lifting. So I don't know if I just made a mistake, which could absolutely be the case. Or what happened there. But anyways, I'm happy to say that this is not a problem anymore. And whee! There we go. And one more. Cool. Perfect. All right. That's done. Do we need... I think we need the ratchet. And then gearbox stuff. This is all engine, engine, engine. Compressor, air condition, radiator, engine. Fuel, exhaust, gearbox. Gearbox, oil filter. Perfect. There we go. Now we're just gonna throw the new gearbox oil filter in there. Perfect. Wonderful. Can't this thing go away? I just want to get it out of the way, so that's why I moved it this way. Now we're gonna move it that way, and hopefully all the way to the end. Oh. Okay, well then just stay there, that's fine too. Whatever. Gone! 14 gearbox oil levels need to be checked, and the scree and windshield washer fluid needs to be checked. Alright. Windshield washer fluid. Say that quickly. Oof. Okay, I need some gearbox oil. Gearbox oil. Transmission fluid. For all intents and purposes. Look, 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 look. And there we go. Perfect. And windshield washer fluid. Which never should be just straight water, but that's okay. Look, 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 look. Done. All right. So I'm gonna put that. Oh man. There we go. All right. Good. Good. Next. Alright, here's our next one. All tire pressures need to be checked and adjusted, and air dryer's compressed air cartridge needs to be replaced. The air dryer's compressed air cartridge. That... I know where the air dryer's... Well, no, I don't know where the air dryer sits on this bus. But we'll figure that out in a hurry. Catalytic converter. So it's on the intake side, is the... This is the intake manifold. There's the intercooler. past the turbo. No, wait a second. The air dryer would be... Where's the compressor? Compressor, 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 compressor. Because the air dryer is on the outboard or on the output of the air compressor. You know what? I'll take the easy way out here. Take the easy way out. Oh, right. There's the air dryer cartridge. I did not buy on a truck, it would be easy to find. For me, on a bus, keep in mind I was a truck mechanic, not a bus mechanic. So while we did work on buses, I just simply couldn't remember where the stupid air dryer cartridge sits. But that's okay. So, air. Is this vehicle heater, air conditioning, no brakes, 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 because this is part of the brake system. Pneumatic spring. Compressor unit, in theory. There it is. Alright. Perfect. So let's change that quickly. I don't think we really need anything to get that changed. But we'll find out in a hurry. Well, that was easy. Done. Now I just have to quickly check the air pressure on all tires. And then we're good to go. Perfect. That. There's that, and I forgot the flipping tool that I need. That's okay though. And here we go. All right. Done. Now we're just gonna go ahead here. Close everything up. And send him on his way. Perfect. 1600. Front axle's tire pressure needs to be checked and adjusted. Cabin filter of the air conditioning unit needs to be replaced. And the coolant level needs to be checked and refilled if necessary. That shall be our last one for today. Front axle tire pressure. Easy. That's the easy part of this. Oops. All right. That's done. And we're gonna quickly grab... Oh, we have it already. That's good. Now we need water. Which again, you wouldn't use water, you would use a mixture of glycol and... Oh, wait. Silly me. You would use a mixture of antifreeze or glycol and... There's the intercooler, there's the radiator. Where do they have the filler plug for the radiator? Back here probably on the... There's the coolant pipe. Earring. Oh, must be up here then. Right. Right, right. There we go. Dunzos. Oh, please. And the in-cab air filter. The in-cab air filter. That one, I honest to goodness, no possible idea where that would be. Or a cabin air filter. Ah, okay, yeah, I remember. I remember. It's underneath here. And then we need this little guy. Like that. Perfect. Remove that, then we remove the interior filter. Gonna grab a new one out of the parts room. Air conditioning, you know. One interior filter, la la la, la 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 la. Comes that, now comes this, and we're gonna quickly put it all back together. Perfect. And off she goes. Actually, can do that. And this, my dear friends, is the end for today. I do hope you enjoyed the episode. We will be back soon with more. Until then, Northern Alex signing off. Thanks for watching, and God bless.